CQDX, CQDX. This is Havana Calling. This is Radio Havana Calling all shortwave listeners and radio amateurs. Welcome to... Unlimited, Radio Havana's weekly feature dedicated to the fascinating world of radio communications.
Hola, amigos, radio aficionados all around the world and in space. You are now listening to a special edition of DXers Unlimited that was recorded in advance of its scheduled airtime because I'm going to be out of town for a few days. So, apologies, because today it will not be possible to provide our high-frequency plus low-band VHF propagation updates and forecasts that you like so much. That, all of you know, has to be prepared as close as possible to the actual airtime of the show. I'm your host, Arnaldo, Arnie Coro, Radio Amateur 202KK, and here's item one of this special edition. It is related to a very interesting topic, minimalist low-pulse count radios. As our future Radio Amateur training program advances at the Plaza and several radio clubs of the city of Havana, the idea is to have every student involved in assembling a shortwave radio, shortwave receiver, so that at the end of the training program, they could go home not only with the knowledge about radio amateur rules and regulations, electronics, basic electronics, antennas, and propagation, as well as the bylaws of our National Amateur Radio Federation, but also they are going to go home with a 40 meters band direct conversion receiver. As a matter of fact, the idea was very well received by the students and the teachers, so now we are gathering and testing the parts to build the prototype. The circuit to be used in the project was designed by a Norwegian radio amateur who passed away at a rather young age while working in the woods near his home. His family and friends preserved the website of Lima Alpha 8 Alpha L-A-8-A-K, and it was there where I found this interesting direct conversion receiver circuit, amigos. If you want to see the circuit diagram, just send me an email to info@rhc@enet.co. Then slowly and phonetically, info@rhc, India, November, Foxtrot, Oscar, Romeo, Hotel Charlie, info@rhc, the symbol for at, enet, echo, November, echo, tango, enet, the symbol for period, cu. Now, stay tuned. On the same frequency or connected to a World Wide Web internet streaming audio. I'll be back in a few seconds after a short break for station ID. I'm Arnie Coro in Havana. This is Radio Havana Cuba. The name of the show is DXers Unlimited. It's on the air twice weekly. Here is now, for your information, our schedule. DXers Unlimited's weekend edition, the one that you are listening probably now or not, I don't know. Maybe you will be listening to the middle of the week program, but the weekend edition is on the air just after the top of the hour Radio Havana Cuba newscast. Remember, the weekend edition just after the Radio Havana Cuba hour, top of the hour newscast. The program is on the air several times all along the Sunday and Monday UTC days. Now, our middle of the week edition is on the air just after the half-hour news with the reruns program for Tuesday and Wednesday UTC days. I must add that the scripts of the two shows are totally different and also that both of them include our exclusive and non-copyrighted shortwave propagation updates and forecasts. And now here is our next radio hobby-related item. It's our program's most popular section, without doubt, and according to your email messages and letters, seems to be the one that you enjoy the most. Here now, you have questions, and Arnie tries to answer them as soon as possible. Today's question came from South Africa. Listener Ian from Cape Town, South Africa, wants to know why he cannot pick up the trans-equatorial propagation signals on the 10 and 6 meters amateur band at his location. And here is my answer. The areas where the trans-equatorial propagation conditions do happen are now very well defined after many years of observations and research by radio amateurs and professional researchers. It's now quite clear that this type of very unusual propagation mode happens between two belts of very well established areas above and below the Earth equator. From an analysis of the area covered by those two areas, it seems that the one south of the equator doesn't reach far enough to produce trans-equatorial signals frequently at your QPH, at least as frequently as they happen at more northerly locations like the Republic of Zimbabwe. According to my own personal observations of the trans-equatorial propagation between South America and the Caribbean region, the two belts are evenly distributed above and below the equator, providing radio amateurs and FM broadcast band enthusiasts with unique opportunities to communicate or to pick up FM broadcast while using very low power and small antennas. Now, here is the second question that I will be answering today here at DXers Unlimited. It came from Germany, from our longtime amigo Hans Joachim. He wants to know what is the typical amateur radio station here in Cuba looks like. So here is my answer. Amigo, the typical Cuban ham radio operator begins his career by fixing and rewiring a 2 meters band FM handy talkie and connecting it to a home rear antenna, typically a J-pole made from TV 300 ohms twin lead, and perhaps later adding a 3-5 elements home rear Yagi. The next step in the typical Cuban radio amateur station starting career is trying to pass the second class operator's test, the one that will open the possibility of using the high frequency shortwave bands, although still with some limitations. Here in Cuba, the most popular high-frequency band is 40 meters because it provides year-round communications with all of our Cuban archipelago and some nearby areas of our nations. The third phase of the startup, either adapting a professional transceiver, usually removing from the fishing boat, or practically build a transceiver using whatever parts are locally available. Among the most popular designs of homebrew rigs are the Islander and the Hawaii. The first one, an almost all vacuum tube rig, it's a hybrid, and the second one, the Hawaii totally solid state double sideband QRP or low power transceiver. Since the last Amateur Radio Federation National Convention, the circuit boards for a much more advanced solid state radio have become available at a very reasonable price, and that's why at this moment many Cuban radio amateurs are involved in assembling it. I hope, amigo, that this answers your question, and just before I finish this segment of DXers Unlimited, I must add that the most popular high-frequency antenna among Cuban radio amateurs is the half-wave inverted D-dipole for the 40 meters band, that also works quite well on 15 meters, and to which sometimes a second 20 meters band dipole is added below in parallel, making it an effective and low-cost three-band antenna system. The typical urban ham radio station here uses the half-wave inverted D, and it's able to fit the antenna and the stations where not enough space is available to install the antenna in a totally horizontal configuration. Nowadays, the most popular 2 meters band antenna for FM operation is the homebrew Slim Jim, an original British design in the low takeoff angle antenna that is certainly superior to the classic J-pole omnidirectional antenna. Thank you very much for listening to this special edition of DXers Unlimited, amigos. And let me remind you all that we do see ourselves, yes, we do verify all accurate reception reports. I'm sure we would like very much to receive your reports. And after checking they are correct, according to our program schedule and content, we will then send you a nice QSL card. Send your QSL reports, we will send you reports, comments about our program, and any radio hour related questions you may want to ask. Send it to info@email.cu or via email to Anicole, Radio Havana Cuba, Havana, Cuba.
And that's all for today. This is Anicole, Radio Amateur CO2KK, your host here at Radio Havana's DXers Unlimited, saying 73 and very good DX.
DX to you too, Anicole.